let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down, come on, brothers, let's go down, down in the river to pray. As I went down in the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way.
Welcome, everyone, to our First Parish online Vespers service. Our tech person this evening is Rebecca Keller-Scholl, and I'm Reverend Catie Scudera, and we are both part of the rotating leadership team for these Thursday Vespers services. Vespers is one of the traditional monastic prayers of the hours at sunset. In our UU Vespers, we may have poetry, music, readings, meditations, prayers, blessings, and always a contemplative practice. We mute all but the leader to create sacred space, and we record our service so we can share it with others on YouTube. So you may stop your video if you wish to be off camera. And should you have a problem, as we may have already had, with hearing or seeing something that you think you should be hearing or seeing, please bring it to our attention in the chat. And if today's technology just doesn't work, or we leaders make mistakes, or Zoom is not doing what we are accustomed to it doing, if we can't figure it out, that's okay. We will take it as part of the practice of being together in this virtual gathering, in patience and in imperfect but beloved community. We'll do our best, offer what we can, and do better next time. Let us begin. As we light our chalice, symbol of our Unitarian Universalist faith, we read words from modern Black poet and professor Dr. Elizabeth Alexander. This is her poem, Praise Song for the Day. Each day we go about our business, walking past each other, catching each other's eyes or not, about to speak or speaking. All about us is noise. All about us is noise and bramble, thorn and din, each one of our ancestors on our tongues. Someone is stitching up a hem, darning a hole in a uniform, patching a tire, repairing the things in need of repair. Someone is trying to make music somewhere with a pair of wooden spoons on an oiled drum with cello, boombox, harmonica, voice. A woman and her son wait for the bus. A farmer considers the changing sky. A teacher says, take out your pencils. Begin. We encounter each other in words, words spiny or smooth, whispered or declaimed, words to consider, reconsider. We cross dirt roads and highways that mark the will of someone and then others who said, I need to see what's on the other side. I know there's something better down the road. We need to find a place where we are safe. We walk into that which we cannot yet see. Say it plain, that many have died for this day. Sing the names of the dead who brought us here, who laid the train tracks, raised the bridges, picked the cotton and the lettuce, built brick by brick the glittering edifices they would then keep clean and work inside of. Praise song for the struggle, praise song for the day, praise song for every hand-lettered sign, the figuring it out at kitchen tables. Some live by love thy neighbor as thyself, and others by first do no harm or take no more than you need. But what if the mightiest word is love? Love beyond marital, filial, national, love that casts a widening pool of light, love that with no need to preempt grievance. In today's sharp sparkle, this winter air, anything can be made, any sentence begun, on the brick, brink, on the brim, on the cusp, praise song for walking forward in that light. For our contemplative practice this evening, you will need something to write on and with. So while we settle into the present moment through the power of music, I encourage you to identify a writing utensil and something to write on, which you can then use later in our Vespers service.
I certainly haven't been shopping for any new shoes, and I certainly haven't been spreading myself around. I still only travel by foot, and by foot it's a slow climb, but I'm good at being uncomfortable, so I can't stop changing all the time. I notice that my opponent is always on the go and won't go slow, so's not to focus. And I notice he'll hitch a ride with any guide as long as they go fast from whence he came, but he's no good at being uncomfortable, so he can't stop staying exactly the same. If there was a better way to go, then it would find me. I can't help it, the road just rolls out behind me. Be kind to me, or treat me mean. I'll make the most of it, I'm an extraordinary machine. I seem to you to seek a new disaster every day. You deem me due to clean my view and be at peace and lay. I mean to prove, I mean to move in my own way, and say I've been getting along for long before you came into the play. I am the baby of the family, it happens so everybody cares, and wears the sheep's clothes while they chaperone. Curious, you're looking down your nose at me while you appease. Courteous to try and help, but let me set your mind at ease. If there was a better way to go, then it would find me. I can't help it, the road just rolls out behind me. Be kind to me, or treat me mean. I'll make the most of it, I'm an extraordinary machine. Do I so worry you? There was a better way to go than it would find me. I can't help it, the road just rolls out behind me. Be kind to me, or treat me mean. I'll make the most of it, I'm an extraordinary machine. Oh, if there the road just rolls out behind me. Be kind to me or treat me mean. I'll make the most of it. I'm an extraordinary machine.
Let us now light candles to represent the joys and sorrows present in the quiet among us today. Together, let's take a deep breath in and let it out. Let us release the tensions in our body, wherever tension is stored for each of us, the jaw, the shoulders, the guts, or the limb. You are welcome to take a stretch to reset your muscles and ligaments to be more restive. Let us release tension as we breathe in and breathe out our prayers. As you continue to breathe deeply, bring into your hearts any sorrows and joys you're carrying with you this week as we hold this space for our community and for the world. We light a candle for the joys. Deep gratitude for those we anticipate and those that are a surprise. And then a candle for the sorrows. Know that there is a deep sympathy and compassion here for all that is causing you suffering. And then a candle for the world, where both suffering and joy are plentiful. And we are all inextricably interconnected with all other living beings on this beautiful earth. Let us continue our breathing and our mindful concentration as we pray together these words from Euro-American UU Minister, Reverend Vanessa Southern. So much undone, so much to do, so much to heal in us and the world. So much to acquire, a meal, a healthy body, a fit one, a lover, a job, a better job. Proof we have and are enough, just around the corner of now. And up against it all, the reality of all that falls short and the limits of today. We honor the limits. If your body won't do what it used to, for right now, let it be enough. If your mind won't stop racing or can't think of the word, let it be enough. If you are here utterly alone and in despair, be all that here with us. If today you cannot sing because your throat hurts or you don't have the heart for music, be silent. The world won't stop spinning on her axis if you don't rise to all occasions today. Love won't cease to flow in your direction. Your heart won't stop beating. All hope won't be lost. You are a part of the plan for this world's salvation. Of that, there is no doubt. The world needs its oceans of people striving to be good to carry us to the shores of hope and wash fear from the beachheads and cleanse all wounds so they can heal. But oceans are big, and there are parts that don't feel up to the task of the whole some days. Rest if you must then, like a swimmer lying on her back who floats, or the hawk carried on cushions of air. Rest in this gathering made for weary lives in space carved out for the doing of nothing much but being. Perhaps then you will feel in your bones, in your weary heart, the aching, healing sense that this is enough. Even this, that we are enough, you are enough, enough. For these and all the meditations of our hearts unspoken, we say, Amen. Our reading this evening is The Summer Day, not quite seasonal. It's The Summer Day, written by 20th century New England lesbian poet Mary Oliver, And in this video, it's also read by Mary Oliver herself.
Who made the world? Who made the swan and the black bear? Who made the grasshopper? This grasshopper, I mean, the one who has flung herself out of the grass, the one who is eating sugar out of my hand, who is moving her jaws back and forth instead of up and down, who is gazing around with her enormous and complicated eyes. Now she lifts her pale forearms and thoroughly washes her face. Now she snaps her wings open and floats away. I don't know exactly what a prayer is. I do know how to pay attention, how to fall down into the grass, how to kneel down in the grass, how to be idle and blessed, how to stroll through the fields, which is what I have been doing all day. Tell me. What else should I have done? Doesn't everything die at last and too soon? Tell me, what is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life?
I love that poem. I'm a huge Mary Oliver fan over here. When mulling over this Vespers service, I found that quite a few books borrow that last line. What is it you plan to do with your one wild and precious life? A lot of books borrow that line for their title. Self-help books, an anthology for those in addiction recovery, a book about death with dignity, the memoir of modern LGBTQ hero Edie Windsor. Euro-American writer and counselor Jane Taylor was inspired by this poem to think about what she'd do with her one wild and precious life. And it made her think about how much life she had left, leading to some math about her estimated remaining hours. The idea was to put some fire under her to figure out her priorities. And for any of you who are familiar with the musical Rent, you may know off the top of your head that there are 525,600 minutes in a year. Now, if you divide that by 60, you get 8,760 hours in a year. Though 8,760 is still a very big number, I find it a little easier to manage. So for any of you interested in putting some urgency beneath what you will do with your day-to-day wild and precious life, think about how long you might expect to live, at what age you think your life could be over. A bit morbid, yes, but as the poet said, doesn't everything die at last and too soon? So if you take those number of years you think you may have remaining and multiply it by 8,760, maybe in your head if you're a little better at math than I am, but on your calculator, that might be on your phone or nearby if you're like me. You multiply those years by 8,760, you will get the number of hours you may have left. And remember that some of those hours you should definitely be asleep or eating or cleaning yourself up. When Jane Taylor found her potential number of remaining hours, she realized she had some questions for herself about what she intended to do with that time. What choices will I make? How am I going to invest my hours? Who am I going to spend my time with? What projects am I going to focus on? What dreams am I longing to express and embrace? Tonight, I'd like for us to take time with that paper and writing utensil we found earlier to journal about these questions, mull over them, maybe take them away from Vespers for further consideration. And to make sure we think about our own lives and not someone else's life, let me share with you another Mary Oliver poem called The Journey. One day you finally knew what you had to do and began, though the voices around you kept shouting their bad advice, though the whole house began to tremble and you felt the old tug at your ankles. Mend my life, each voice cried. But you didn't stop. You knew what you had to do, though the wind pried with its stiff fingers at the very foundations, though their melancholy was terrible. It was already late enough, and a wild night, and the road full of fallen branches and stones. But little by little, as you left their voices behind, the stars began to burn through the sheets of clouds, and there was a new voice, which you slowly recognized as your own, that kept you company as you strode deeper and deeper into the world, determined to do the only thing you could do, determined to save the only life you could save. Tonight, we mull over what we are determined to do and to save our own lives by giving our hours the meaning we intend for them to have. So I'll say those questions again, and if you're live on Zoom, I'll put them in the chat box. But you can write these down. Here we go. What choices will I make? How am I going to invest my hours? Who am I going to spend my time with? What projects am I going to focus on? What dreams am I longing to express and embrace? We're thinking about choices, investing hours, who we'll invest in, what projects to focus on, and what dreams you still long for. Rebecca will share with us about 4 minutes of music as we write. May this time be fruitful for us all. Take these questions with you as you go. Amen.
I know this rose will open. I know my fear will burn away. I know my soul will unfurl its wings. I know this rose will open.
Thank you all for participating tonight. As we end our gathering, I invite you to take your hands off the keyboard, maybe put your hands on your heart, and imagine your fellow first parishioners, physically distanced, but spiritually close. Our closing words are from Euro-American educator and spiritual teacher, Dr. Donna Markova. I will not die an unlived life. I will not live in fear of falling or catching fire. I choose to inhabit my days, to allow my living to open me, to make me less afraid, more accessible, to loosen my heart until it becomes a wing, a torch, a promise. I choose to risk my significance, to live so that which came to me as seed goes to the next as blossom, and that which came to me as blossom goes on as fruit. Amen. Please type your goodnights and goodbyes and stay for our closing song if you like. We'll wave and log off in silence when it's finished. Have a peaceful, peaceful night.
You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase into a weapon or a drug. You can be the outcast or be the backlash of somebody's lack of love. Or you can start speaking up. Nothing's gonna hurt you the way the words do when they settle near the skin. Kept to the inside, no sunlight, sometimes a shadow wins. I wonder what would happen if you say what you wanna say.
See, I wanna see you be brave with what you wanna see. Hope you guys enjoyed my cover of